Hi, this is Shiva Rajaya from vitalcoaching.com. We are talking about coupling dynamics, and the topic for this video is blind spot check. We are checking communication tactics that you can use with your partner to really create a deep connection. You will notice that when you are out there in life, sometimes there are some aspects of your own personality or your own being that you cannot necessarily see. You might be doing certain things that are a turnoff or that are sabotaging your chance of success in the world, or that are doing something that are going to lock you within frames of immaturity, and you might not necessarily see that. So very often having the reflection from a partner is going to be a really powerful experience to help you grow to the next step. So the way you do this blind spot check is you sit down with your partner and you simply ask them, give me like three things, three qualities or three aspects of my life that you think or you feel could improve me. Where are the areas where I'm underperforming? Where are the areas where I'm not really showing up in my full power? And you give really your partner the opportunity to give you some solid, deep, profound feedback. And the idea is this: you want your partner to respond or give you hints to the point. The goal is not to give you a full, you know, half an hour dissertation and explanation about you know, those aspects. It's more pointing out straight to the point and offering this feedback as an open invitation. There is no pressure, there is no control, there is no demand, there is no emotional charge behind it. This is very important. It's just, here is a reflection, a little bit like mirroring somebody's personality or somebody's aspects, and then you receive that. So for instance, your partner might say, you know what, I have the feeling that you could dive into having a more active social life. I have the feeling that you are working too much right now and you need to take some free time. And I have the feeling that you should put more energy, or you could put more energy into your body to get back in shape, because I have the feeling that you are underperforming on that level. So when you receive that, what you're going to do is take one point after the other and reflect on how this feels in your system. Does it feel right? Does it feel a little bit, you know, out of place or out of balance? And is this something that you would like to try to apply into your own life? So what is very important is that if you are the one who is offering this feedback and offering the blind spot check to your partner, because you are going to reflect, right? You receive first 3 points and then you are going to offer that to your partner as well. So when you offer this reflection, again, it's very, very important that you remove the emotional charge that you might have around it. You might want to point out to something that you are really triggered by and offer that reflection from a place of hurt or from a place of wounding, from a place of vindictive feedback, you know. And this is exactly what you want to avoid. You want to have a really clear space where you simply say, you know what, I'm offering that to you, and it's really up to you to apply it or not. Another element that is really important once you offer this feedback or this reflection is that you drop it. This is not an ongoing discussion that you want to have every day. It's a one-time thing, and then you can do a check-in, you know, maybe 1 week or 2 weeks later, if your partner is open for that. But you are not going to come after your partner with controlling practices or controlling tactics to check in. You are not given the right to keep them accountable on that, okay? Unless they ask you to. The idea is you offer it and then it's up to them to apply that or not. Exactly the same the other way around. If at that point, you don't have the time or the energy to focus on what your partner is suggesting, you simply drop it and allow yourself to follow your truth, okay? So you can practice that with your partner, but you can also practice that with friends. You can make a post on your social networks, for instance, on Facebook, and ask your friends for feedback or a blind spot check. Okay, this is how we call it. I hope this makes sense. I'll see you soon for another video.